Hi everyone! In this video, I'm going to be highlighting 5 of the best gaming speakers in 2021. To give you a good idea of just what exactly your cash can get you, I have selected those I feel represent the best one in the market at their respective retail prices. If you could get one of these for free, which one would it be and why? Let me know down below in the comment. First on the list, for gamers who want excellent sound but also prefer to complement their battle stations with extra RGB lighting, the Logitech G560 LightSync, which has the best RGB. It's all well and good to have an RGB-enabled mouse or headset or keyboard, but aside from a few gimmicks like imitating the sirens in Grand Theft Auto, it's still more about aesthetics than functionality. Logitech's G560 changes that, using RGB LEDs in a way that feels transformative, if only the effect were paired with slightly better speakers. The G560 features 6 high-powered RGB LEDs per speaker, 4 facing the rear and 2 for the front. At maximum brightness, they can be a little distracting in a dark room, but a nifty button at the top of the right speaker lets you tone it down or turn them off completely. A pleasant rainbow color cycle works as the default mode, but jumping into Logitech gaming software is when the magic happens. The software allows you to choose between 2 control modes for the speakers. Hardware control ditches the software and uses Bluetooth or AUX input devices for lighting. You get the same rainbow color cycle that also acts as an audio visualizer that flashes and brightens to the beat of the music being played. The G560 provided rich, immersive sound regardless of the genre. Whether I use DTS 7.1 surround sound with a preset gaming equalizer profile or standard stereo, the audio broadcast the full range of everything I needed to hear: voice work, sound effects, and music. Because the G560 supports surround sound, you can even position your speakers a little creatively and feel like a whole game is taking place right around your ears. The sound from the 2 circular speakers is comparable to what you'd hear on a high-end headset. However, if you've never gamed with a subwoofer before, it's difficult to explain just how much of a difference it makes. You don't simply hear bass music and explosions, you feel them in your gut and, depending on where the woofer is located, maybe even in your feet and legs. Next on the list, best for the size, we have the Razer Nomo Chroma. The Nomo Chroma speakers definitely make a visual impact. The all-black tubular speakers sit on 4-inch struts that extend out of a circular base. Around the edge of the base is a programmable LED light ring, hence the Chroma part of the name. Each speaker has a 3-inch woven glass fiber full-range driver, meaning all possible frequencies are reproduced by these drivers only. The Razer Nomo Chroma is absolutely dripping with Razer aesthetics. The speaker themselves have that matte black plastic finish that we've seen so many times on Razer's mice, keyboards, and Bluetooth speakers. And that's not even mentioning the RGB lighting that pulses underneath the speaker stands. A fun, quirky addition that will undoubtedly be hated and loved in equal measure by the gaming community. The light show, which can be controlled via the Razer Synapse app, a familiar sight for those of you that use Razer mice and keyboards, is actually a surprisingly neat addition in my opinion. In Nomo Chroma's music section, considering different types of music applications, Nomo Chroma also adds a bass subwoofer control knob. When the bass subwoofer gain is maximized, the low frequency performance will be relatively prominent and the sound will be calm, full, and explosive, brings a full sense of shock. The Nomo Chroma speakers delivered consistently impressive audio, offering lots of immersion for cinematic titles and clear directionality for competitive games. They're also quite loud, pumping out more than enough sound to fill my room. Testing them on Overwatch, the hammer of Reinhardt sounded extra beefy and detailed on Razer speakers. High-pitched noises, such as the silence of Genji's sword or laser, sounded quite sharp, combining style, decent sound quality, and a useful feature set for a reasonable price. The Razer Nomo Chroma tick all the right boxes. Next up, we have a quite known name that's been dominating the industry of speakers for a while now, the Bose Companion 2 Series 3, best overall. Bose has been a big name in the world of hi-fi and headphones for decades, but it's less well known for its desktop speakers. but with all the audio expertise at its fingertips, you would expect it to make some of the best computer speakers on the market. The Bose Companion 2 Series 3 is a compact, affordable system, and with its elegant black design, it should fit more most computer setups. The Bose Companion 2 Series 3 speakers measure about 7.5 by 3.2 by 5.8 inches and are also both lightweight, with a small difference of about 0.5 pounds between them. They come in the form of an upright rectangular block. They're also only available in black color and with a volume control headphone jack and RCA inputs located on the right speaker. You're definitely going to be reaching for it a lot more than you will be reaching for the left one. Bose is always known as the loudest speaker in class, and the Companion 2 is not an exception. With an average sound quality, because it doesn't have a separate subwoofer, it does not have a tight bass response. However, it is strong enough to deliver a wide space of sound. The high quality sound seems as though it's emanating from a larger sound stage than provided by the two Bose speakers, a feature that I'm sure that you'll also appreciate. On the gaming front, I booted up Warzone, and the little speaker's strength in the bass department helped accentuate weapons firing and the explosions they caused. And now we have the best Bluetooth gaming speakers. We have the Logitech Z407. Logitech is a household name when it comes to affordable computer speakers. Logitech's affordable speakers are known for balancing solid audio quality with low prices, and they ride that line better than pretty much any other competitor. The Logitech Z407 Bluetooth computer speakers come in a matte graphite gray to nearly black color. It seems like a full sound system all on its own, with the inclusion of a downward firing subwoofer that rumbles, as well as two 10-watt satellite speakers. To give you full control over the volume, bass, and more, the Z407 also has a wireless control dial. What's great about the two oval-shaped satellite speakers is they feature a detachable stand, which allows users to angle them as they please. Sound-wise, these speakers pack a punch as you'd have expected, and music listening is very pleasing to the ears. The audio is also clear. If you're a bass lover, you'll love the separate rumble coming from the subwoofer, but don't expect a room rattling on one with a subwoofer of that size, especially if you put it below your desk. For a study room or apartment, though, it's perfect, but not room feeling. Since it boasts plenty of rumbles and produces terrific sound quality that will satisfy most gamers, as well as users looking to consume media, whether that's music or movies. And its added perk of being versatile will benefit every type of user. And finishing the list, we have the best for less, the Redragon GS520 Anvil. They sound great and look awesome. What more can I say? Oh, they also come at a bargain price. Design-wise, they look quite cool for their price. The GS520 Anvil RGB speakers are entirely made of hard plastic with a beveled design, metal mesh grilled and L-shaped RGB strip, and a chrome plastic accent Redragon logo, which is glued onto the speaker. The back of the speaker units has a plain matte finish with a recessed groove around it for styling. The base of the speakers has foam padded feet. The right speaker weighs 390 grams and the left speaker weighs 367 grams. The total weight, including the cabling, is 758 grams. Each unit houses a 5-watt dynamic speaker driver, which works well at reproducing treble, mid-range, and bass without muddliness or distortion. Since the Redragon Anvil GS520 comes with RGB lighting, there is a button on the top of the right speaker that allows you to change the colors between 6 different settings. A simple press of the button changes the color, and again, there's no special software that's needed for the RGB lighting. The sound quality was clear and crisp, even when turned all the way up. Though turning speakers all the way up isn't something I normally do and certainly don't suggest. While listening to music that had a bit of bass to it, the bass came through the speaker very well. It wasn't overpowering or under-impressive in any way. The highs and the lows were crystal clear either when you're game or listen to music. But don't expect much else. After all, they are something that were made to not hurt your bang that much. Alright guys, we came to the bottom of this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video to be helpful. If you have any questions about the products mentioned in this video, you can leave a comment down below in the comment section, and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Until then, stay safe and peace out. Take care. Bye bye.